Легко. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to our movie club. Today we have an Indian movie. Surprisingly, we did not make one for a long time. What was the last one, Vasant? Could you remind me?
Yes, it's Tare Zamindar, which is translated into English, like stars on the earth.
It was about special boy. Do you remember who? Yeah. Who needed special treatment or something. Okay. So this one is different, I would say. But before we start, so it's an indie movie, it's a fresh one, right? It's, yes, 2014, I can see in my notes. So it's a fresh one. And before we start, so it's an Indian movie. What do we know about India? What kind of stereotypes do we have from the top of our head? Vova, what do you know about India? When someone says India, what two things you immediately remember?
In India, a lot of trains.
A lot of trains, okay. What else? Do you know something about cow in India?
No.
No, they are in some, as I understand, in some, how say, regions, they are sacred animals. So they are like gods. How? You cannot eat them, you cannot actually punish them or touch them. Can we touch them or not? Can we touch them, cows?
Yeah, we can touch them.
Okay, what else?
In India...
You don't know, I see. Okay, so from Russian stereotypes, what do we think about India? India, it's yoga, first of all, and then... Yeah. And then it's some spiritual, education or something. So some people from Russia go to India to find the idea of life or something like this, I will stay there, I will eat sun, I will practice yoga, and I understand why I am on the earth. So, that's our stereotype, what we have. Leila, anything else about India?
The ladies' jewelry, right. Their clothes are really different. I allow the kind of, what do you call it? I don't know, necklace on their forehead.
On the, you're speaking about dots?
Yeah. It has to be a special name.
There was a special name, but I don't remember it.
Maybe Vasant, no.
Vasant, how we call this dot?
It's called Bindi in Hindi, but she's not talking about the dot. I think it's a necklace on the forehead.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. It's another jewel. Yeah. It's,
and also being
hanging. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Ivan, go on, please. Ivan?
Yeah.
You were saying something.
Do you remember our joke? So Indians with feathers, not with dots. So it's how we recognize those different Indians. Okay, Gerard,
and also, I was told that there are a lot of religions, right?
Yeah, a lot of religions, a lot of cultures, right, inside.
Yes.
And actually, partially our movie about this, right?
Yes, there is a religion named Hinduism, but actually it's a lot of religions inside, Hinduism is not only one religion.
Okay.
We have more stereotypes, dancing and singing, in Bollywood movies, all the very famous.
exactly.
And the food, the food in India is also, they eat a lot of rice and it's very spicy and mostly vegetarian. They don't eat as much meat as we eat here in Europe or America.
Yeah. Dances is very famous. I remember that when I first time in my life, I meet an Indian woman and I asked her, do you dance every day? And she answered me, only when I go out from my house, only on the street, not in the house. Something like this. Okay, Jishy Liu wrote that it's world oldest democracy. Is it?
I think so. I think it has a...
They were
the biggest, yes, because it's the most populated democracy country.
Another fact, right? It's almost has the same population as China, right? It's kind of a par.
But China is not a democracy.
Maybe more than China now, I think. Which probably is amazing. I didn't know that.
It's huge. Okay, curry based food. Curry, it's kind of condiment, right? How we call it?
It's kind of like a sauce or condiments they put on top of everything. Everything, I think, right? Besides everything.
Yes, you can't avoid, no.
Okay, Vasas, we all know that stereotypes, they are like funny. They have some part of truth and part of like mistakes or lie or misunderstanding or something. What is your, I don't know, favorite stereotype about India? My favorite, you know, is that every family in Russia has a beer, you know, as a pet.
Yeah, but I think the most common stereotype is they think that we are all Hindus, you know. It's a Hindu country, but actually it is not. So many religions and cultures, ethnicities, and even I was introduced to new religions in this movie, you know, in that song, particular song. He was searching for God in various places. So I was amazed by that. What is this religion? Because I have ever seen something like that, you know. He was beating himself and he was trying to touch something. So it was all new to me. So there are so many out there.
Beating yourself sounds like Filipino Catholicism.
Yep. Very similar. Yeah, very strange. Okay, let's go to the movie. So whoa, do you prepare character list or something? Cast of the movie? No, you don't. Okay, let's improvise. So who you can remember in the movie?
The woman was Jagu.
Jagu, okay. It's a girl, right? Lived in Belgium somehow and returned to India, right?
Yes.
Jagu, okay. Who else? Lady. Okay, alien. What was his name? I don't know. In Russian translation, it was a pian or something.
In English, was tipsy. In English, was tipsy.
Ah, okay. So now I understand the joke. Tipsy? Okay. Who else? Who was the guy who loved lady in Belgium? Safahar or...
Sarafan.
Vasans, help us, please. What was his name? Sarfazar, okay. And who else? Guru of Sekta. Is it an understandable name? Guru, teacherly? Can you say so? It's like a spiritual leader or something.
Yeah, it's not really a name of a person, I don't think. It's a title of a spiritual master or an expert. Yeah.
Vasans, was it a sect or was it just a Christians or something? So this, do you remember this guy's in white? Some protagonist.
Yes. Yeah, it's just a Hindu religion.
Okay, Hindu religion. Okay. What was his name? I forgot.
Takas Pidji.
Okay, let's call him as a guru, right? Can understand. Okay, who else? Father of the lady, right?
Papa.
Okay. Leila, who else?
Oh, I think that's enough.
Okay, it's
and, her mother, I guess.
Father, yeah. Okay, mother was not important, and friend from the village. Yeah, friend from the village. Okay, so we know all the cast. At least we know how to name them, right? Guru, lady, alien.
The boss of the lady.
But Jagu, it's easy to pronounce for me.
Yeah, for me too.
Okay, so what was the beginning? Leila, could you tell us?
First of all, I just see some clouds and lovely dancers and music. I love music and dancing, you know. And then the clouds, one cloud is moving. And then I could see the UFOs. And suddenly one of them landed in. But I think a naked alien.
Mm-hmm.
appeared on the scene, and then the UFO went away, left him.
Yes, here. His ship went away, right? His saucer, as teacher right. He told us. Okay, what could you describe this alien? Was he human-like or frog-like?
I mean, his eyes are a bit strange for me, you know. Big eyes, he always opens his eyes wide. And the way he talks is, of course, strange. And there is a kind of, how can I say, surprising look. You know, he's looking everywhere in such a surprising way that...
I guess we can say he started at everything, right?
Stared
at everything, yeah. He was like, I don't know, he was studying every subject very scrupulously, right?
I didn't understand if he really liked what he has seen or was he amazed at the things he has seen. I didn't understand that.
What if he has no emotions at all? You know, he's just, you know, studying like logically.
You're right.
Maybe. In fact, he has feelings after, right? We can learn.
Of course.
Okay, what happened with this guy in the beginning?
Suddenly he saw Indian man. He started running towards him. This Indian man was walking along the railroad. And this alien man, tipsy, he has a necklace, a kind of green, bright stone on his chest. Mm-hmm. And then when he saw this Indian man, he ran towards him. And he started to talk to him, but they didn't understand what they were saying. So suddenly the Indian man grabbed his necklace and started running away. He is a thief.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, he couldn't get his necklace, but...
Leila, what is the difference between steal a thing and rob someone? What is the difference?
You rob the bank.
Mm.
Or... Yeah, you could have been robbed. But if you use Teacher Lee,
I think it's about how you do it, right? So if you do it,
if we take money from somebody or someplace, we use rob. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, we usually use steal. Steal is usually done secretly. Robbing is usually done in front of people.
Yeah.
Give me your money. Stealing's kind of like you open their purse and take something out and hide it and you walk away.
Yeah. How is it called? Pickpocket or something?
Pickpockets is they stealing. Rob people, but they do it by stealing secretly.
Yeah. Okay.
But he didn't steal secretly. He did it by just looking at his eyes, grabbed the necklace, and started running away towards the train. And he took the train, but meanwhile, this alien took his, what do you call it, cassette player? Because it's old.
So he was robbed by this Indian guy, right?
Tape recorder, yes, Teacher Lee.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so it's how he started, right? And we learned that this... can we say it's a medallion or something that we use on our necklace?
It's a kind of, I think, remote control or something like that in order to open the door of the UFO, the spacecraft.
You know, I'm talking about some kind of thing. It's usually round, circular, and we put photos inside and we close it. Medallion, right?
Well, if it has a picture inside of it, we call it a locket.
Locket, okay.
If it's a round object, a flat disc, we call it a medallion.
Medallion, okay. So it looks like medallion, but it actually was a remote control to your ship, right? So this guy now in trouble, right? He cannot maintain, he cannot order.
And he's naked.
And he's naked, right? It would look like a big problem, I guess, but, but yes. Okay, we, you know, the movie is pretty long. It's pretty long because mostly because of dances and singing, but also because of many, many small details. I guess that we should not, you know, go to every small details, but we should go just with, you know, with the stream, with the flow of the movie. So let's try to summarize a bit. Gerard, could you please continue?
So the alien, so KP or PK?
PK or Tipsy or something.
Tipsy, yeah. PK, also, yeah, I just find out that PK is the name of the protagonist, the alien.
Okay.
This guy didn't know how to talk our language. Well, in the movie, it's supposed to be Hindi. And he needed to take the hands of a person for some hours to get the language. But first he tried with men, and men didn't like that because they took, like, it was related to sex, you know, and all women didn't like that either.
If someone on the street come to me and took all my hands and just hold me in this way, I would surprise it, to say the least, right?
Yes. So it looks like in India, if someone touch someone, that has sexual implications, connotations.
Well, just imagine that someone do the same, like, to my wife, right? So, when they took my wife to the hands and stay and do nothing. So what would I say? Man is in trouble now, right?
You wouldn't say anything. You would hit him in the eye.
No. I don't hit. I shoot. I'm joking. Okay, so he tried to learn the language by this, I don't know how to say it, process, right? Alien super abilities or something.
Yeah, he found a friend. This friend, eventually he paid him a prostitute because his friend thought that he won't take sex. Mm-hmm. Actually, he wanted this knowledge of the language, so he could talk, and he got that eventually. So he could speak.
Yeah. He took the girl for 6 hours, he said. Right?
Yeah, the girl was sleeping at the end.
Okay, we forgot to mention the two other protagonists. Let me cover this story, right? So we learn that in Belgium, right? In Belgium, there is a Indian girl who studies there, I guess. I did not
yes. know
exactly. And he met another guy, and they... What language they were speaking? English? With Pakistan guy?
It's also Hindi. Okay.
Hindi?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he met a Pakistan guy, but she did not recognize that he is from Pakistan. So he looked like an Indian guy, I guess, for her or something. So they, like, fell in love, and it was about it went to the marriage almost. And they tried to have a blessing from, to got a blessing from their families. But their families were strongly against this marriage, right? So, and it's the way how we learn that the father of the lady is under influence of this religious guru, right? Religion guru. And as I understand, another family, Pakistani family, is against the marriage as well. But they decided that true love breaks everything, every border, and decided to meet in the church, if I'm right, or some governmental building. But when lady went there, what happened, Leila, do you remember?
Yeah, he didn't come. And just a boy came and gave her a letter. And in this letter, he told that it is not possible for them to get married because one of them is a Muslim and the other one is, you know, just from different religions. So it can cause a lot of problems in the future, he wrote. Yeah. She was shocked. She started crying and she left the church or whatever. And
he went home, right, to the family.
Yeah, yeah. He left Belgium. She left Belgium, right.
Yeah, and actually, it was It was mentioned that the letter was pretty vague, right? So it was not said, as far as I remember, nothing about Muslim or something. It was said like in vague way. We are different. We in different cultures, yes. Right? Yes.
So we that's just why it was the wrong letter, right?
Yes. So we just, you know, cannot be together because why? Because we are different. That's all. So many yes. words, but no sense.
It's also in capital letters, you know, so you can't find the handwriting of the person.
Yeah, yeah, and it's written in English, right?
Yeah.
And English does not have like, does not change words with genders, right? So it can be any gender. So it's it was a part of the plot. That's why it's important.
Yvonne,
so,
I remembered now after you had said this, her father said this. You can't marry him. He's a Muslim. Do you remember?
Yeah,
you're right.
Because father was controlled by this guru and they said, you know, just impossible because they are bad people, they will, we know what they say.
Yeah.
All the things. Okay, did I miss something in this story? No, I guess.
Yeah, I think I thought about a plot hole, mm-hmm. you know, for sure, but now I check and it's, you mean the guy is from Pakistan and she's from India. Yeah. The language is not the same. I thought, I find out that in Pakistan they speak Urdu, which is a similar language, but pretty different. So it's impossible that the girl didn't find out that he was from Pakistan.
Yeah, that's why I asked that they talk it in English. And I put this question on our Padlet. So there is kind of, you know, Vasan, are we right? So you can recognize the Pakistan people, right? You know, immediately, right? If you meet a guy from Pakistan, would you recognize that he is not from India or not?
No, actually, they also speak Hindi, I think, because it's all have the root language. So Urdu is also have connection with Hindi. So it can't be so different. But I believe some people still speak Hindi because, you know, Pakistan is not a different country. It was one of the states in India, but people moved from here. There, yes. So then Hindi still lives there.
Yeah,
so
no
special accent. You can't tell by their voice if they're Pakistani or not.
No, I think it's pretty hard to distinguish. Yeah,
we all know that, you know, it's just one big territory divided by, you know, by Westerns. So,
but even in America, you have English from the north, from the south. There are different dialects.
Well, I can relate to the situation in a way, you know, that we have Ukrainians and they speak Russian and Ukrainian. So when they speak Russian, I cannot recognize them almost. But when they speak Ukrainian, I can say they are Ukrainian. So it took a lot of, you know, a lot of hearing to understand that this guy not Russian. So if it's not long, I could be missed. So I guess
if it's not long, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so we know about lady, we know about this guy, so we are ready to the plot, right?
That old man was funny, remember? While they were trying to buy the ticket.
Trying to buy two tickets? No, I don't remember.
Tickets to the...
to the poet.
Yeah.
Actually, the lady was a fan of some poesy, how we call it, poems?
Poems, right.
Poetry, right? Poetry, probably.
Poetrist,
yeah. And there was a like kind of a comedy. So let's not forget that the movie is a comedy, right? But as I understand, it's a way to hide like controversial questions asked in the movie in a way of the joke. So we making jokes, but these jokes, you know, should make us ponder what is happening, what is going on, right? Kind of this. Yes, a comedy about controversial topic, kind of a special language, you know, you cannot forbid me. Yeah.
You can talk about things when you're joking that you can't talk about seriously.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's this movie. So we cannot say that, you know, some Muslims make terroristic acts, right? People say, yeah, what you just said. But if you joke about this, you know, again, this, you know, guys with black clothes did something, it's okay.
Shakespeare had a famous quote in one of his plays.
Mm-hmm.
Many a true word is spoken in jest.
Right.
In other words, we say it like we're joking, but we really mean it's true.
I love it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a way, right? It's a way to like avoid criticism, right? You cannot criticize me because I'm just joking, you know, guys. It's not serious. I'm just joking.
Yeah.
I'm going to write this.
Put it in the chat area. It's in the chat area.
Yeah, many a true word. Many. Why we have it? Many a true word.
Oh, a word. The goes with word. Many a word is kind of an idiomatic expression.
I see.
Same as many words. Many words. Many a word.
Many a true word
is spoken. Yeah,
many a true word is spoken in jest. Good one.
It's like, yeah. Ivan, you're such a jerk. Well, I really believe you're a jerk, but I'm saying it like I'm kidding, you know.
I got it. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
The compliment.
Yeah. Okay, Leila, let's continue. Let's summarize a bit of the story. So what happened when they all now in India? What city it was? Do you remember?
Her family rejected Singer. They didn't want to be in touch with her anymore because they were angry with her. And she started working in a television company.
Yep.
Okay. And she was looking for interesting stories, attracting the audience, or what you call it, you know, just people watching TV.
Well, I guess we can say it was a news program, but this was not really a news program. It was like a talk show or something. So people...
But it's so stupid, you know. A dog is in depression. I mean, and she knew that this program isn't worth making.
Mm-hmm.
But her boss insists on her making these kind of programs. And suddenly they took the metro to go to their home, I guess, with her friends. And they met this alien. This time he was in different clothes, wearing a yellow helmet and on the train, and just giving people a kind of brochure, right?
We call it handouts, I guess, or something. So when we have a list of piece of papers and we hand them in the metro or something. How we call it?
If it's a flat piece of paper, we call it a handout. If it's a trifold,
mm-hmm.
if it folds into three pieces, we usually call that a brochure.
No, it's a handout then, right?
Okay, just a handout.
Because if you see the God, please tell me, right? It was written like that.
Yeah, it was. So this guy, an alien, right, a gypsy guy, he got the answer. So who could return me my remote, you know, God can. So let me find the God. So he print a lot of handouts. If you know where is the God, just, you know, call me. I will ask God to return me my medallion.
Okay,
flyer. Yeah, another good word, flyer. Okay, so she meet him. It was like she met him. She, as far as I remember, found this funny, right? This interesting. Something is happening on. Maybe we can make a show out of this. So it was her feeling, initial feeling, as far as I understand. Jean, can you summarize something about this guy? What was he doing all this time?
What do you mean, the alien?
Yeah, alien.
Yeah, he thought that God would bring him his remote control. But it's curious because he just arrived to Earth and just he lost his remote, and all the time was preoccupied by getting his remote back. So what was his initial mission? Why he came to Earth? It's not that clear, because it's only, you know, it should do should be more worried about doing his mission and then to come back to his planet.
Yeah, we don't know his original plan. We don't know, because he was so worried. But I can relate to this, right? If I cannot manage my spaceship anymore, so I could be really worried about this.
But Ivan, Gerard, I don't think that he has a mission.
We don't know, right?
I think they just, I don't know. I don't think he has the mission because he just came in the world in an, you know, suddenly out of the blue, he was naked and suddenly the UFO gone. I don't know.
Well, think about this, Layla. Why would a spaceship come to another planet and drop off one alien? He had to have a mission, or he was taking a vacation in a new destination.
Why naked?
Well, maybe they don't wear clothes on their world.
Okay.
So, like the birds.
Yeah, like my dog is always naked.
But to me, you know, I would think if I was going to send an alien to another planet, I would make an effort to study the other planet and make my alien look similar to the local people so as not to scare them to death, you know, or stand out in a bad way. So I would think, so this doesn't make sense to me at all, but.
Yeah, see. Okay, so this guy, he was like really ugly looking, right? He has a helmet, he has some strange clothes when she met him. So whoa, why he had this helmet, strange helmet?
The god is watched him.
To be like, what's the word for this? To be visible, right? For the god. So god can see him. He is so bright. And this helmet, he will distinguish it in the crowd. Strange idea, I would say. Okay, Gerard, what happened after? Did she make the show?
The movie, I think he eventually fall in love with the girl. He wanted to stay to with her.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he have a confrontation with a guy. He find out that this guru had the remote. He said that it was a jewel, sacred jewel and something. He found in the Himalayas, but it was a lie.
Well, I would summarize it like, you know, this guy, alien, he started to learn many things about the culture, about the different religions, and all this strikes him like, what the hell, right? What the hell do you have there? And he started to ask questions. And his questions, they were like funny, they were awkward, they were like, you cannot answer to them, right? Why you told that this man is a Muslim and this people is Christian? Because without clothes, you cannot distinguish them from each other. So what makes him Muslim, right? What makes him Buddha and all these things, right? And why do you have this confrontation? So he became to be a public person, right? Because he was a kind of a freak, I would say, right? Can we use this word? So people like to watch him in the news. Oh, look at him. this freak, he's again ask strange questions. And what he told to the public, Leila, do you remember?
No.
About wrong number.
But I stopped watching it.
Ah, okay. So I can tell you. So this guy publicly said, I know why your God don't answer you. You just have a wrong number of the God. So you just lost the right number. You have to find it and everything will be fine. So that was his like idea. The idea that makes him popular, I guess.
Okay.
Okay, and eventually he started to make troubles to guy, to our guru guy. Because people start to think more and stopped to pay him, right? To buy his like consultation, I don't know, or something, to stop making sacrifices. How we call this sacrifice? Charity or something? When people donate to the church.
Just donations.
Donations. So he started to lose donations and he did not like it. And he decided to eliminate this troublesome guy, right? In a way. What was his idea?
He agreed to have a face-off you know, in a live show, to have a debate on a live show, to answer his question, all those silly questions. Then, yeah, they arranged a show, and on that live show, just before the show, he lost his friend, you know, in a bomb blast. So he was so upset, that the alien was so upset, and he was idle and trying to prove that the guru is a fake person. So he wanted to prove that his sayings were wrong about Jaggu's love. So he again wanted Jaggu to make a call to help university and
yeah, romantic moment, right? Leila, you missed this romantic moment, I guess. So Jaggu called this Zufar, or what his name, Zar.
Yeah, but that was the end part of the film. I watched it.
Ah, okay.
You cheated.
How can I miss that romantic part?
But one one interesting thing is the guy, Sarfaraz, committed suicide last year. You know, his real life love was not a successful one. He committed suicide.
But this guy, he was in love with Jaggu, and he called to this last place of work every day just to ask if Jaggu is looking for him. Did she call today? No. Did she? Every day. So when she finally called, the whole crew of this company were like excited. Finally, he will stop to ask us every day. Pakistan.
Who embassy. Found the number?
Number of embassy? It was easy, I guess.
No, Tipsy. Alien found.
Ah, but Tipsy did not found the number. He just asked right question, right? He asked, have you seen his name on this letter that you read? And she said no.
But in a way, he found it.
Okay, let's open this riddle, right? Fasans, can you? What happened with this letter?
Yeah, in the letter, at that time, there was another lady who was about to get married, but she was holding
a cat,
and she wanted Jaggu to hold that for a minute. So she gave it to her and went to talk to the priest. But at that time, a small guy who misunderstood that the girl who was holding the cat was the person he was about to deliver, because someone told him to deliver to the girl who holds the cat. So he mistakenly gave that letter to Jaggu. So she thought there was no signature and no sign of Sarfaraz. So, but she thought it was written by him. So she went out. And again later, Sarfaraz came to the place and he saw the same letter. And he also thought that she wrote that letter and he left, because she, in that letter, it told try to contact me. So he didn't contact her later.
So how we call this new married guy? So bride, right? The woman, and what's the name for the man?
Groom, the man.
Groom, okay. Groom and bride. So they both read the same letter, which was addressed not to them at all, to another lady. And both of them decided they were abandoned by another part. That wasn't true, right? So that's the gist of this story, that's the idea of the story. Well, it could work, I guess. So life is complicated. It's hard to imagine, but okay, it could be, I guess. It was written in English, as I said, in very... Usually correct me, how we call it? Vague way. In very vague way. So you cannot recognize who wrote this, for whom. So, but if I got this letter, I would call first, right? So did you write it? Okay, so we are at the final, right? Almost. So this guy, alien, he was in love with this lady, right? At the moment.
Yes.
Gerard, do you remember? What he tried to do?
He wanted... she knew that he was in love with her. You know, he brought a... he wanted to choose a name for him. Because, you know, KPK is a nice name. And mm-hmm. he brought a car. He brought I'm in love with you, Jago.
Mm-hmm.
But she didn't end up. I think she found when she was reading the names, he found the name of Sarafat. And she didn't find out the car that said, I love you.
Yeah.
And eventually the alien went in the final with the guru. They had a bet with a guy, and the guru said that the Sarafat betrayed Jago, but he eventually proved that that wasn't true.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, so, and he got his remote, right, and could now control his ship. Layla, do you remember what he bring with him to his
plan? Yeah. The one thing I would like to mention here, her father accepted that man. What was his name? Safa? Yes.
Yeah. He's a groom guy, right? Guy from.
Yes.
Yeah.
Her daughter's boyfriend, and it was very good because the guru couldn't achieve his aim. And then our alien has two suitcases full of cassettes.
No, not only cassettes. Do you remember? It was
batteries as well. Batteries, a lot of batteries. And because he's still holding the tape recorder. And Lee, just how romantic he is. He recorded the girl's voice. A lot of cassettes. So, he's romantic.
Yeah, she asked him, what is on these records, right? Why do you need him? And he said,
he wants to listen to her voice.
Yeah, but when she asked him what he said, he said, I recorded many things, you know, cars, people talking, cats making sound.
Perfect.
Yes, everything just to remember the years. And when she started to check, cassette by cassette, she found that it's only her voice on every tape. So it was a like eureka moment for her, right? She finally understood, wow, maybe this guy has some feelings to me. Vasanth, please.
And was a post end scene, you know. It's a funny scene. He brought some other aliens along with him for research purpose, and he told them four rules, you know, don't go around naked because sex is happened in closed rooms, and war and fighting is placed in open space and something like that.
I like it. Actually, I like it, this wording. He said that you cannot show your passion and you cannot kiss people if other people watching. But you can hit, you can spread, you know, angry, you can yell on people because this is okay, you know. And it's kind of part of my culture as well, you know.
Yeah. And there is a difference between the language and the thoughts also, you know. When people say I love fish, then you know, it doesn't mean they love fish. They love to eat fish.
Yeah, so so he made yours like a touristic destination for aliens now, right? So we are so funny that they go there to to see what we are doing, right? Okay, we covered the story, I guess. So there, are, but I think we like forgot about many moments, many details. I don't think we should mention everyone. But if you have your favorite lines that we missed, please tell us. Lee, please.
How did the guru get his remote? Was the guru the thief at the beginning?
He has a lot of like authority and reputation. So when someone found a strange thing, something strange, something beautiful, he bring the thing to guru and say that like it's my donation to you, something like this.
Okay.
So what was your favorite line in this movie?
My favorite line was when PK
mm-hmm.
PK analyst to the letter.
Ah, okay. When he just played detective on the letter, right? When he understood that this letter belonged to who knows whom. Okay, what sounds, please?
I love the moment when he was trying to give the photos of Mahatma Gandhi, you know. He thought that in rupee notes there was the image of Mahatma Gandhi. So he thought, okay, if we show this guy's image, they will return something else. So he's trying to give his photographs and stamps that printed his image. So it was a funny one. Yeah. It's about how human feels towards the money, you know.
Yeah. Okay, Leila, what about you? Have you
like
have this moment with Colin?
No, Colin it's like with sound.
Okay. Gerard?
Yes. His strategy to avoid people walking him, you know, to put stickers with the gods in his face. So anybody would hit him. That's a good strategy.
Okay. So in the old time, so just, you know, you cannot avoid Russian stories when you have me. So in old time, some people make a tattoo with Stalin on this. So you cannot shoot this, you know. Mm-hmm. You cannot shoot him because it's
wow.
It's but it was stupid, you know. It prevented nothing. So just a joke. Okay, so we have a lot of questions on our Padlet. Actually, we answered a few of them. One of them, for instance, was I asked why lady did not recognize Pakistani guy. So when what language they were talking. So let me choose another one. So his name was Tipsy, and it's a funny story. I like this joke. I don't know why, but it's kind of funny to me. Okay, let me ask something else. What kind of TV shows are popular in India? So is it talk show, interviews, cooking show? What is the most popular?
Yeah, it depends on the people, but the most television rating point was earned by soap operas, you know, the television series.
Soap operas, okay. Yeah, so serious, okay. Yeah. Okay, I see. Well, because in Russia is talk shows and interview shows, you know, very popular, just impossible popular. So we don't have. I remember in Spain, cooking shows was very popular. Gerard, am I right?
Yes.
On Spanish TV, whenever I watch switch on TV, I can see someone cooking something. if I switch on TV in random place in Russia, I can see some interview, you know, some smart guy will tell another smart guy how to live and what we are and all these things.
Another show in Spain is gossiping about celebrities.
Celebrities, okay. Leila, do you watch TV? What is popular in your place?
I don't like watching TV. I only watch TV in the mornings, the news program. Mm-hmm. It is a very serious channel. But my mom watches a lot. And during this lockdown, cooking programs have become so popular.
I see. Yeah, cooking is kind of popular, but not top one there. I don't.
I think they are cooking a lot nowadays.
Yeah, usually don't watch TV. We've been all this. So. Okay. Another question. Let me choose one. So why this starship was so big for one alien? What do you think? It's a question from Vova, right? So the starship was huge, but alien was only one man. So what do you think? What do you think? What was the answer?
Maybe in the ship was other aliens.
They're just waiting for him.
No.
I guess it's, you know, it shows us how rich and affectionate this it's another civilization, you know. They're so they don't spare any, how we call it, spare any charges. Actually, there is a idiom, don't spare any. How we say that? Don't save any money.
Normally, we say money is no object. Uh-huh. They spared no expense.
Ah, spare no expense. Okay, so we need to send one man. Spare no expense. Send, you know, the whole ship like for him. Okay, another question. Layla mentioned it, and I kind of surprised as well. So main characters have like big eyes, you know, so like almost like aliens. Why? Is it a beauty standard in India or what? What's that? What do you think?
No, I don't see big eyes. Only just the PK, because he had to stand out from the other actors. So he had to...
Vasant and Lady and Guru, they like... They...
I think it's just a genetical, you know, thing. Coincidence.
So, but I guess it's because, you know, it's because it's... So beauty is in the eyes of watcher, right? How we say it?
The beholder.
Beholder, yeah. So maybe that's why you like these actors and actresses, because they look this way, I guess. But it was kind of common feature when I watched this. Yeah. So interesting. Beauty standard, I guess. Okay, what? How the powerful the managers of God in your country? Another question. So by the managers of God, we call this church, this all this, you know, cardinals, what's the name, priests, yes. So how powerful they are? What do you think, well, in Russia? Can any priest or any another manager of the church order you something?
No.
No?
Only you, Ivan.
Well, actually, we have like the top guy in the church. He usually meets the president, like on every, you know, celebration or something. We have him, but I don't think that he is in charge of something. He's just a decoration, my understanding of this. So.
A figurehead, yeah. Putin and the top religious guy are on the same sheet of music. They're on the same page.
Yeah. I don't think they have like real power in Russia. But interesting that they have a lot of like privileges. So they don't pay taxes, for instance. They have a lot of buildings, for instance, in Moscow, enormous amount of buildings. And government pay for this. So they don't have any expenses. So it costs a lot for society. Yeah. Actually, I'm not actually strongly against this. So some of these churches, they are part of our history, the architectural monuments and something. But I'm against, you know, new churches when we build something for our taxes for no reason. So that's the thing that I don't understand. Okay, Vasant, what about India? Do those managers powerful?
Yes, very powerful, and they have. An ally, you know, I'd say that they have friendship with the political parties, because you cannot deny their support, you know. Even people have no problems when you mock them, but mock the God, but the religious leaders, they can gather people and they can provoke the people to come stand on the streets and protest against the any film or government. So the government always afraid of guys who have announced themselves as a leader of a small group or anything.
You know, your comment made me think again, and I think I should be corrected. Because when I told that religious leaders has no power in Russia, I thought about Christian religions. But in Muslim regions, it's different. So they have a lot of power there. So some mullahs, or how you call them, some Muslim leaders, they have a lot of power. They can, you know, make uprising in one moment. So that's why Russian government from time to time have to show some army there in this region, or some military exercises or something else. And it's actually not a joke. I mean that it's a big, huge problem. Actually.
Of course. I agree.
Yeah. Vasant, please.
Yeah. In my opinion, this crew decided to mock mostly the Hindu religion, not much Christian or Muslim, because there is no definite definition of Hindu religion. So nobody can easily offend an Hindu religion. And the minority is always under the inferior feeling, you know. when you mock them,
you mock no one. Yeah, if you blame white men, you blame no one, right? So no one will answer. Yeah, no minorities. Always blame the majority. So actually, Vasans, I had the feeling that you know there is a question on my Padlet, so I wrote it in this way. Don't you see that the movie has special feelings for Islam? Because in the movie, so the train, the terrorism was made by Muslim people, but it's, you know, it's okay. So nobody said nothing about this. And when the dance is something, nobody want to criticize them, but everyone criticizes, you know, Hinduism. And it's not the only movie, Indian movie, when I see this. You know, another one, popular one, Slumdog Millionaire, how we pronounce it, I don't know. So in this movie, again, Muslims are bad, good guys, and all the others are bad guys. So I kind of worried, why it's so?
That guru, right?
Yeah.
He's not Muslim.
He was this guru, he was a Hinduism leader, I guess. Hindu.
Right. But yeah, a lot of people believe in him. So I think religions are being mocked here as well.
Yeah, but Leila, what I'm trying to say, you know, when people criticize religions, right? They criticize like Christianity, Hinduism, like Buddhism, but they never dare to criticize Muslim Islam.
But they have to criticize.
But they don't.
Why?
You can see this in the movie, right?
You don't know why?
I know why in my country. But in general.
In Denmark, was it Denmark?
Yeah.
Or Holland?
Yeah. I don't know.
In Holland, one artist drew a cartoon mocking Islam. And riots and burning and killing everywhere. You can't mock Islam or you will have dead people and fires and explosions all over the place. It's a fact.
Yes.
In the US, one preacher in Georgia, one preacher burned one Quran. And in Afghanistan, the Muslims got so angry, they started killing UN soldiers. It was one guy in a country far away burned one book, and they went on a killing rampage and killed innocent soldiers in a different country. It makes no sense. That's why people are afraid to mock Islam, because I'm sorry, but Muslims are crazy.
Intolerant.
That was this guy who drew a kind of caricature.
Yeah, yeah, another thing. Yeah.
In France.
Yeah.
In France, right.
Yeah, yeah. So let's find. We understand why, and that's why I give my credit to this movie. At least they showed something. You know, they showed.
Yeah,
this,
yeah.
We understand why they cannot say, you know, this openly. But at least something. Yeah.
I thought, you know, the guy, the PK, the tipsy, had a pamphlet with different religions. But I don't know how was the pamphlet with Muslim, because you cannot.
They did not show it, right?
You cannot. Right. They would be mad if you had a drawing about the prophet or something God.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't draw a picture.
Don't dare to do that.
Yeah. Okay. Hassan, please.
Yes, the guy who died in the bomb blast, you know, the friend guy, he's Robert Downey Jr. kind of guy, you know. He had a past, the bad past, you know, with the drugs and all the drug dealers thing, everything. And he was also involved in 1993 serial bomb blast in India. You know, it's a train bomb blast. So there is a resemblance with that. You know, he has a connection and just a reminiscence.
You mean the actual actor, you mean?
Yeah, the actual actor got arrested, and he was in prison, I think, during this movie. And he got parole to get shot, get the shooting thing.
In real life, you mean, Wasam?
Yes, yes, in real life. He possessed a gun, you know, without a license. So he got arrested and he bought that gun from the guys who were in, who plotted the serial bomb blast. So that was the case, yeah.
Okay, let's find some positive question. Something different, if we can. So, have you ever witnessed a wrong number situation? No. So, when you nowadays, it's not that easy, right, for our children because they have a phone book. But when I was young and it was a rusty phones, and you have to deal the number, but your hands with your finger, you know, pull stone, we call it. So, have you ever deal a wrong number, Leila? Did you?
Yes, but not a romantic one happened, you know. Nothing happened. I usually say, I'm sorry I disturbed you. Have a good evening or have a good day. Mm-hmm. That's all.
When I was young and very stupid, it was our kind of, what's the word for
fun, having fun, right?
And entertainment.
Prank, yeah.
Yeah. So you call random people during the night and asking, why don't you sleeping? Or something like this. But I was
funny. There's a lot of movies about that where teenagers do prank calls and they get in trouble.
Yeah, yeah. And I finally got in trouble. It's always happened with teenagers. So I accuse this entertainment.
Yeah, but I'm not asking about the real wrong number. I mean the fake prophecy, you know, the fake.
You're asking when someone puts the wrong number deliberately on the commercials or something just to, I don't know, to make some fraud or.
I have seen a preacher who had a CD cassette, you know, CD cassette, and he said that if God gave me this CD. And it will cure all the diseases you have, you know. He places that on the forget of the people. It happened.
Oh, man. What amazes me is people believe that stuff. Yeah, you know? It just amazes me. It's like,
you know what happens here nowadays? Your telephone, you know, rings and you answer and you can hear this. The police station is calling you. I am blah, blah, blah. You're expected to give this money and come here.
It's a fraud or spam call. We have a lot of them. And actually, we have a lot of victims of that in the old people.
Yeah. Old people.
Well,
I did, Ivan? When I received this call, I said, oh, really? My husband is a police guy. I'm going to give the call, give the telephone to him.
Yeah, but they don't care, Leila. They are well protected. They are well protected. In Russia, it's a huge problem. Huge problem. Many people under the scam. Old people, young people. Sometimes, you know, your child went to you and asked, "Father, I need your phone to send some SMS." So
right.
Because they attack children first and ask you just give a father phone and make something, and it works. So it's be careful, you know, it's social engineering. Yeah,
okay. Right, you're right.
I read once that, you know, it's a billions of dollars every year. So this scam business, so it's a very huge. Yeah. Okay, let's go to the slides. So time flying, so let's make some funny slides from this. Okay, I'm sharing.
Oh, it's so cute.
Okay, let's stop it somehow. Resume. Okay. Okay, we can see it. PK, strange clothes, strange helmet. Actually, it was more another question, but I forgot to put it on the Padlet. So I remember I was told that there are that the Indian society, what's the word for this? I don't know the right word for this, but they are like Puritan or something. So you cannot see like a naked woman in the movie or something. And the clothes must be very, you know, long and not provocative and something, or else society will be very unhappy about this movie, right? So I noticed that in this movie, I cannot say this lady were like very Puritan or something. What's the word for this?
Yeah, so, she's wearing shorts, yeah.
Yeah, so culture changed or what happened?
Yes, it's gradually changing, but no one would complain about that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so 10 years ago, it was like almost impossible, right? Or 20?
Yeah. And more than that, at some point kissing is not allowed. No, you can't kiss her. You can. They would show their heads and closer to their lips, and they would show some flowers in front of the camera. You know, between them and the camera.
So they actually beeped, or how we call this? You know, sometimes we beep a swear word. So they beep it kissing. So.
Yeah, America used to be like that back in 1920, but not anymore.
Well, I guess
this is something stupid, you know. When I was at the age of 5 or 4, I just remember when there's a kissing scene, mommy said, close your eyes.
As Alien said, you know, it's okay to hit someone, but not okay to show that you're kissing someone.
In early American movies, the husband and wife slept in separate twin beds, single person beds, and then they slept in double beds. And now today, you know, anything.
Yeah, today. Okay, this guy has a lot of necklaces, right? Made from trash, I guess. And also, if you look like very scrupulously, this is a Nazi symbol. But it's a
Muska Wasan? Is it Muska?
There's a Buddha symbol that looks like a mirror image of the Nazi symbol.
Yeah. Why they put it here just to, I don't know, just to attract our attention, I guess.
To be controversial.
to be more controversial than ever. Okay, let's start with this one. Vola, could you?
The alien.
Gypsy.
Gypsy ran to the man who took his remote control.
Right. Anything else? How we call this road?
Road for trains.
For trains. Railroad, right? It has rails. Railroad. How we call this? We have rails and we have wooden thing on the railroad. How we call this wooden thing?
We call them railroad ties.
Ties. Okay. Ties.
Yep.
And it's very, I don't know how it's in India or in America, but in Russia, these ties, they are deliberately put in this way that it wasn't inconvenient to walk there. So they measured this distance to make you like walk, so that to prevent people to walk there. What sounds?
Now I understand, because in India, they put some stones. I think now I understand. It makes sense. Okay.
But once I read the articles, and you know, there was a research. So what the distance must be between ties to make this uncomfortable to walk? And they say, like, you know, 60 centimeters. So if it's 60 centimeters, you are you have to walk like a Japanese geisha, you know, so you don't like it. And at the same time, you cannot skip one.
I never read that. Okay.
Okay, funny fact. I will share it. Okay, what could you describe the dress of this guy, of this Indian guy? What he's wearing?
T-shirt and.
So this like a towel on his head. Do you know? It's a turban, I guess. Can we say so officially? This, you know, towel on the head.
Yeah, we call it the turban, yeah.
Okay. Okay, the railroad, like in the middle of nowhere, I would say. So some desert or something.
Yeah, middle of nowhere is a good way to describe it.
Okay, another one. Vasans, could you please?
This is where they were about to watch the poet show. And they are in short of cash to buy a ticket. So they are trying to share their whatever they have got, and they decided to watch the first part by the female and the second part by the male, and we can see actually, how do we say that, the grand appearance of the front appearance of the building, there is a word for that.
It looks a little gothic, or
it's gothic.
Yeah.
I know a word. I don't know how much it applied to this. It's facade or something. Facade of the building. So the front part of it.
Facade.
Facade.
French word, facade. Yeah, it looks a little religious in its design, or maybe just Gothic. Yeah.
Yeah, it's good because it's Belgium. It's, you know, the half of the country like this. Okay, so, is it any special relationship between Belgium and India or something?
How? No, just they are for the higher studies. So I think Belgium has a big university in there. I hope.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure. Okay. Okay. So anything else, or should we go? Ground stone surface is a plaza.
They like a lot of arches. All the windows and doors, are, a lot of them are arched.
Yeah. Actually, I like Gothic. I don't like that we have so few in Moscow, because it's an, the period is very old. So Moscow was a village at that time.
I noticed one woman's wearing a purple coat. She kind of stands out.
Yeah. Yeah. And he's kind of watching on them with a, with a not happy sight, right?
And between them, you can see the steps to the building are red, which is kind of loud and unusual.
Yeah.
It's a carpet or special, like, you know, usually it's on the celebration or some shows, they put a red carpet to the stairs just to show that it's a special place.
Literally, how could you be so observant?
It just jumps out at me, red and purple. Everything else is gray and blah, but, you know, purple and red are bright colors in this scene.
Contrast, okay.
Yeah, contrast.
Okay, another one. Leila, what can you say about this?
I can see her father, and that's a stupid guru.
Mm-hmm.
And the father, as soon as he received the news that she's going to marry the Pakistani guy, and they were talking on the net, and he took the computer and just brought it to the guru.
Yeah.
That was the scene.
Tell and, her the truth, right?
Yeah. So I can see it's a kind of church style, I think. I'm not sure, but on the right, I can see the guru's photo. The guru has got a necklace, could be gold. He's fat, he's wearing a white kind of uniform, I don't know.
Robe, maybe.
I'm not sure about the room, the big room.
Look at the walls.
I mean, there are some lamps, crystal, I think. And yeah, teacher, the clocks on the walls. But it is not that luxurious room, right?
So this photos of guru on all the walls, you know, they attract my attention. So in Russia, it's impossible to see such a picture because it's too much like pictures of one man. So I can imagine maybe two photos of one man in one room. So, but if it's more, I know that I'm in kind of a sect or something. So
it's like Taiwan, Chiang Kai-shek. One man is on every money bill, every government building. His pictures everywhere you go, you see the one guy. It's like the only guy they know, their hero, their only one hero in all their history. It's like you get sick of seeing the picture of one guy over and over and over. Yeah.
It was the same in this movie. So they have his picture even in bathroom everywhere.
You know, instead of his photos like this, they can put on Buddha's photos, right? I like him.
Yeah, yeah. For instance, or someone else. Let's see.
No, okay, not someone else. If you mean.
Yeah, this symbol. Can you see there are two flags or something, some kind of a two white clothes? I don't know, flags maybe.
This guy is for Buddhism, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't know. What sounds? The other for Buddha, this Hinduism.
Which one?
I mean, what kind of gods they have, this religion? It's Buddha, right?
No, it's Hindu religion. No? Lord Shiva.
Okay. Yeah, so what is this circular symbol on the flags? Do you know?
Where is that?
close to the door, if you
okay, call it. It's his, this guru's symbol, you know. He would have a certain website and he would have an emblem, something like that, you know. So represent himself.
Okay.
I think they purposefully avoided the orange color, you know. Usually the Hinduism has the orange outfit, mm-hmm. But I think they purposefully avoided that.
I see. So you cannot sue them for this.
Yeah.
It's not Hinduism anymore because there is no orange. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go forward. So Vova, do you remember this moment?
Yes, the boy
mm-hmm.
give
Jagu.
Jagu the letter.
Mm-hmm. Delivering a message, right? What she has in her hands?
The cat.
Cat, right? Cat, and we call it a basket, right? A basket with a cat, I guess. Yes. Okay, where they are?
In church.
In a church, right? What are on the wall?
Icons
maybe, but icons must be small, right? Something that you can took with you, I guess. So
when they cover up an entire wall, we call them murals.
Murals. Okay. So chairs, and it's soft chairs, right? Can we say so? Impossible in Russian church. In Russian church, you must suffer. So it will be wooden benches. Okay. Leila, I interrupted you.
No. I was just trying to follow you. I said leather chairs. I think.
I see.
Yeah, red leather.
Red leather.
That's kind of a medieval style. Medieval style, like those little tacks that go around the edge, like it's you pin the leather to the wood.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a medieval style there to me.
Yeah, it is. It is. It must be in Belgium. Belgium, it's a history, right?
And she's wearing, to me, a man's watch. Women like to wear little thin watches, but she's wearing a man's watch.
I do as well.
Do you? Okay.
we are not against Leila. Okay. Another one. So it's a kind of a metro or train, or what is this? What sounds? Do you know?
Yes, that's a metro train.
And it's New Delhi, right? Or what?
Yes.
Okay. Could you please describe this photo? What he's doing?
Yeah, he is distributing the handouts. Saying missing God, and if you find him, contact me. And you can see his outfit, the suitcase. I think he has it for holding a pan. You know, he is eating every time. And you can see a Sikh with a turban.
Sikhs, they are not numerous, right? It's a minority, right?
Yeah, they are minority. Yeah.
So you, and I can see that, you know, without a Sikh, I would say that it could be a Moscow metro as well. You know, people wear a casual mm-hmm. dress, so nothing yeah. shows me that it's mm-hmm. Indian metro.
Yeah.
without Sikhs, but we have some Sikhs in Moscow, so it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't Sikhs mm-hmm. wear turban, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
But not only them. As far as I know, they are obliged to wear the turbans all the time, right?
Yeah, because they have a long hair and they have to.
Yes.
I remember that even in airports they refuse to, you know, to take it off. So it's always nightmare for security guards.
It's an offense, you know. They would not take out their hair turban.
Funny. Yeah, really funny. Okay. Oh, anything else about this picture?
No.
Nothing. Okay, on the left I can see this can you see this metal kind of fence? So it's interesting because we use it a lot in Moscow to form crowds. So sometimes let's say in the evening the whole city goes to the center of the city. And the end, they go like out of the city. So these metal barriers, they used to create like flows.
Yeah.
Crowd control barriers. Yeah, nice.
We can see a woman in pink wearing traditional Indian dress.
Sari, right?
And the woman with the white blouse, her Her trim around the sleeve looks kind of Greek style to me, but I can't be sure.
Mm-hmm. It's our protagonist, Jari, right? In the white, I guess so. Okay, let's go to the next one. Leila, could you please describe this one?
That was the moment. They are on TV studio, and mm-hmm. she was angry with the show she was going to present, because she was talking about the dog, and the dog is in depression, she said, and suddenly she left that studio and went to the boss's studio, right? And they were talking, and the boss, the man who was about to take off his pants, was yeah. angry, and he said, I'm not gonna let anybody talk about religion because of this religious stuff. I had a kind of three scars on my hips.
Yeah, kind of scars or, I don't know, injuries or something. So he tried to talk about religion before, right? And got some, I don't know, assignation attempts or something.
Yeah, he joined the demonstration.
yeah. So he said, well, I got this and that, and I don't want anymore, right?
So this is the TV studio, and it is well organized, I think.
Mm-hmm.
The equipment may be not too technological, but everything seems okay.
Yeah, it's okay. So, Lassans, what is written on the monitor? Is it in the name of the show?
Yeah, and the name of the show, yeah.
Okay.
Literally, I can see red colors.
Red and blue, right?
Red and blue.
Yeah. I know, you know, in Moscow, in many times, some TV show or talk show, they need what we call statists. So some people who is just go there and sit as an audience. As an audience. So do you know what is forbidden to wear if you go to this show?
No.
So you forbidden to wear black clothes because they make some troubles for TV devices. I don't know exactly what, but they say you can wear whatever you want, but not solid black, not like dark black.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think you know, absorbs light, I think. Yeah, black absorbs the light. I think it could be the reason.
I don't know why. Yeah, maybe. Yeah. So how I know? Because I go to the show.
On some of our shows, there's a little sign that everyone can see, and sometimes it'll say, laugh, people are told what to do, so it makes the show look like, oh, everyone's loving this show.
Yeah. Yeah. Manage the audience, auditorium.
Yeah, yeah.
Clap, yeah.
Well, what he's doing?
He's...
stealing, taking...
Taking money
from donation box. Why? Why he's doing that?
Because he don't have money.
No, not that reason. Another reason. Do you remember? He said, I'm taking only my money. Because I told to God, give me my remote back, and I paid for this. But he did not give me remote back, so I took my money back. Okay, what else you can see there?
I can see the sign in the on the destination box.
Oh, the donation box? You can see the symbol, right?
Yes.
Okay, symbol. Yes, we talked about, right? The symbol. Yes. Okay. Can you see the coal here?
Yes.
White one, yeah. Because it's a sacred animal, I guess, in some I don't know, some branches. What else? Suitcase, some flowers. Or some, what you missed? Sari.
And you can see the threads tied around the...
Yeah, this kind of a catwalk or something. And it has a lot of threads on it, some knots. What is for?
It is a belief. You buy some threads and you can pray for something and you tie it and the God will answer that, you know.
Okay,
will...
so some kind of souvenir from God, right? Some kind of
prayer. They're prayer threads. They're saying, please grant me my prayer.
Yeah, just like a birthday wish, you know.
Yeah. I see. In Christian church, they use candles for this. You buy candles, you light it. Yeah.
Now, a lot of Asia, Chinese especially, they will have three incense sticks. And they'll burn the three sticks, and they'll bow three times, and they'll put the sticks in the sand. And that's how they ask the gods for favors.
I don't ask God for favors, but I like the smell of these sticks. So I have a lot of them in my house. Sometimes I burn them just, you know, for this, atmosphere, for this smell.
Yeah.
Okay, anything else? Leila, have you noticed something unusual?
I'm just looking at the Ko statue on the right.
Yeah. Why it's white, Leila?
Could be the symbol of purity or what? I don't know.
The color of concrete.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's interesting because another stereotype for me, you know, that Indians, they like colorful pictures, you know, everything must be bright, yellow, red. So, then we see white cow. So, I guess just, you know, they run out of the paint or something. So, just wait a minute.
Now, Mexicans, if that was a Mexican cow, it would be all kind of rainbow colors.
Yeah. Exactly. It's how the guy got his hotel, right?
Yes.
So let me describe this. So this guy, he actually did not have a place to sleep in, right? So he don't have money for hotel. So how he found a place to sleep in? He just made a minor crime every evening by urinating there on this wall. And there was a permanent post of police. And they grab him and put him to the jail, as far as I understand, for one night. So the problem solved. And this policeman, he looks very brutal. Like, what are you doing there? He's surprised, to say it, to say the least. Mustaches, beret, some kind of writing. It's is this writing from right to left, right?
Yes, you know, it's left to right, and it says, do not pee here.
So it's...
Oh, is that right? So blatant violation.
Yeah.
Well, you know, if I see some kind of writing in Moscow, don't pee here, I would be surprised. Okay, let's go forward. Bosans, why he has a skirt?
Yeah, because he get this clothes and money from the dancing cars, you know. Somebody has sex in the car, so he took them away. But he doesn't know the fashion, so he mingled them, you know, in the top was a man's one and the bottom was a girl's one. And so everybody was mocking him, you know.
They
offered him. And they can see the turbans, you know, different type of turbans. This is from the another state of India, and it's a tradition. You can see a lot of sweets and snacks on the right side for the sales. And yeah,
so generally, it's a market, right? With
roadside market,
fruit market. I can see a camel. And some kind of device. What for?
This is for sharpening the tools, you know.
Sharpening knives.
Knives,
scissors. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. What else? It's kind of watermelons or melons on the right. And, I don't know what else.
That's not watermelon. What are you pointing at?
Behind the bicycle. Can you see this?
Right in the middle,
that's
right
just
in the
pot. You know, pots. Sand pots.
The what?
Sand pots, you know. For
sand
the...
pots?
Yeah, sand pots.
How you use them? Tell us. Is
to,
that food or what?
To carry waters and everything, you know.
Ah, okay. So it's kind of a jug or bucket.
Oh, pottery. Yeah, we call it pottery.
Okay.
I see. Okay. I saw this watermelon.
At the in this state, there's you can find a unique way of carrying waters. You know, big pottery and a smaller pottery. So it would be like a.
I understand.
One by one. Yeah.
Yeah. So
more than one pottery. Yeah, a lady can carry.
Thank you. When I want to eat watermelon now.
Okay, there are many sellers to my taste, yeah. And guy on the bicycle, he looks like in a casual dressing, right? He is kind of different from others. Okay, but it's interesting. I would like to visit such a place. I like such places. So, something, you know, something authentic, I would say, or something. Okay, I don't know what he's doing. Layla, what he's doing?
I'm not sure. It is in the street market again, right?
Yes, the same market, I guess.
I can see. What are these? These are not carrots.
Mm-hmm. What he has in his hand? What
stamps. It? Yeah, stamps at stamps. The imprints of Gandhi.
And what kind of vegetables or fruit? What are these?
These are new to me. I think it resembles carrot.
Carrots, right?
Mm-hmm. But it really moves me, you know, how we value the Gandhi's ideologies now and the money.
Okay, on the left, I can see this pottery from another point of view. Yeah, we can see more clear from there. Well, it's a good place. But what I don't like this kind of a river. Can you see this water track from one cellar? It ruins my impression. So before this, it would be more interesting. Wow. Everything good on one picture.
Whoa. Here's your color,
yeah. Whoa, could you describe this picture? What can you see there?
This is dome of...
House of?
House of...
His friend, I guess, right?
Yes.
Okay.
There are a lot of trumpets.
Trumpets, right? On the wall. Can you see, guys, this kind of trumpet? Musical instruments.
Trombones.
Do. Yeah.
I can see the fillet only.
I can see a camel.
Camel, right. And they are playing music to camel. Why? To make him dance? What else?
Lola, is he dancing?
I remember this moment, Layla. He wants to grab someone and took his hands just to learn the language. So he just looking who is free, you know, to grab. And okay, electric meter on the left, right? On the wall, we can see this device. It counts how many megawatts you...
Pretty high up in the air. Ours are usually at head level.
Yep.
So you can read it easily.
Yeah. Maybe it's against, you know, stealing.
Yeah, I don't know. Could be. Above the doors, you've got those green panels. Does that have any meaning?
Ventilation, I guess.
No, ventilation, yeah.
Oh, those are ventilation? There's holes in them? Okay.
Yeah. So what kind of symbols, B and reversed B, does they mean something?
I don't know. It doesn't mean anything.
Okay, just decoration.
Decoration, yeah.
Yeah. So, do you know this? You know, in the center of the picture, we can see kind of a wooden device. Do you know why? It's to make carpets, right? To make clothes.
They sew the carpet.
Oh, a large loom.
It's just a cart, I think, just to lay down, you know.
Ah, okay. So you don't think it's a device?
It was made of ropes.
So just a framework with some ropes, strings attached. So it's kind of, I don't know how we call this. You can lie there have some rest. Okay.
Yeah. And this lady is just blowing up air to flame the fire.
Oh, she's not playing the flute. I thought she was.
No.
how we call this guy who is playing for a snake, you know, for to cobra? Snake.
I forgot the name. Yeah.
We call him Snake Charmers. Wah, 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 wah.
It was my impression as well, yeah. Okay, so this is making a fire to make a dinner, I guess. And on the right,
why
I guess.
Maybe he's covering her head. I don't know.
I don't know. Don't ask me.
It's pretty primitive, you know, not just in Islamic religion. Yeah. Some ethnicities also follow such.
So it could be a demand, right, from society to cover yeah. here. Okay, I understand. And on the right, it's a chili pepper, I would say. Some sort. And the quantity is enough for one dinner, I guess. If you're in India.
Vasant, there's an Indian term for a man. It's a swami or a swarmy.
Swami, yeah. Swami it's another name of guru, you know, somebody who is religious leader.
Okay.
We call them swami. Yeah.
Swami, another name for guru. Okay.
Yeah.
That looks like a Chinese cooking wok. Do you Indians cook in that too?
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess the whole Asia use it. We use them as well.
okay.
Let me skip a few. Just you know, just a name a few, right? So this lady is kind of a prostitute, and he found a way to learn language because he can hold her by hands. You know, other women refused this attempt, so that was the way. And she has a lot of jewelry on her arms.
Yeah.
Vasant, do you want?
Yes, but there is a plot hole because he learned language from her, but he doesn't know about condoms. Later in that movie, you know? He was asking questions about condoms. Yeah, that was an irony. Yeah.
Well, if she's a prostitute, she probably does know about condoms.
Yeah. Yeah.
A plot hole. And this red clothes, actually, totals, it's a balahin or something. It says, when we cover our beds from insects.
Well, that's probably not for insects. Is it? That's probably just for
privacy. Yeah.
Attractiveness. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, a few more. I don't remember this, but behind him it's a church, I guess, and people asking for charity, begging for charity. What's the word for this? So they have these cans to beggars, right? Beggars. So it looks different, but they are. Yeah, and people. Don't have the shoes when they go to the church, right? All the shoes outside. Okay. Another ritual. Don't know why. Don't know what it is. Okay, let's skip it. He got something. I don't know. When he need money, he got money from beggars. That's his idea. And he said they are so kind. They always like not against this. Another ritual. Whoa, do you remember this?
Yes.
What happened? Was in a costume, right?
Yes. Was in a costume of
of a god.
Of a god.
Or goddess, Shiva, or someone, I don't know. So when our guy, right, Tipsy, he was looking for a god, and he said, finally, I found you. So give me my medallion back. Funny scene. Okay, but the guy on the left is ugly as hell. I would say, wide door. Yes, door is really wide, yeah.
You know what? An interesting thing is Lord Shiva is originally supposed to be in a black color. But somehow people changed it to blue, you know. They don't like black, even if it's a god. You know?
Don't say this to Americans, you know.
That's right. Shame on you.
Okay, some kind of show. We almost don't have time. That's why I'm sleeping. I'm looking through to find something, you know, interesting. Okay, Leila, what is on this picture? You noticed this. You mentioned it.
He had two suitcases, and while they were talking, he forgot to take one of them. So one of them dropped, and he started running after the bus to take the other one.
Yep.
So all the batteries and some cassettes are on the dirt. Yeah. Dirty sands. And he was running after the cassettes, sorry, after the suitcase.
Yeah. And he got a chance to learn what he has on here on these cassettes, right? On all these cassettes.
Yeah.
So Vasant, why it's so ugly? I mean the territory. Is it a desert or something?
Yeah, there is a place like that, yeah. But it's a desert. It is almost like a desert with sandy, a salty sand.
Yeah, is it huge like territory?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
It's
so
very huge.
And it's a coast, right? Coast of the ocean or not? Only
not exactly a coast, but just an empty place. You know, you can't find anything. It would almost look like a desert.
Okay. So you know, I did not expect a desert inside the India because inside India, because India for me, it's, you know, it's a green something, you know, with a forest.
Yeah, it's not desert sand. It's more like dirt. What caused all the vegetation to die in this area, Vasant? Do you know?
I don't know. Maybe I should look at it in the internet.
It looks unnatural to me.
Yeah. Yeah.
they hide in something, right? They hide in something. It's not natural. Okay, Vasant, the final slide. What do they have? What do they do?
Yeah, she's reciting her own book about PK. She wrote everything she had experienced with him. And once she finished, her dad started to whistle, you know, just like in the old days, good old days she used to have. And we can see a lot of books in the shelf and a poster of that book. And a microphone on table.
Yeah.
Stand and water bottles, everything.
It looks like she's doing a reading. Sometimes an author will read from their own book so people can experience what he was feeling and thinking, maybe, you know.
Yeah.
Kind of a session. You can ask something, you can get your book with a autograph, we call it, right?
Yep, autograph,
Autograph, yeah. Actually, I have a few books from Afters because I like them. I want to support them. I went to this session, yeah. So it's a way for me to show my, I don't know, my what, dedication, my love, right? Okay, nice slides. So my last question for you guys. So the whole alien civilization, right, came to the Earth for what? To get married, to get a groom for one girl, to fix one marriage, right?
So it never explained, Vasant, why he came to the Earth?
We just assumed that it's for a research purpose, you know. He was supposed to have his own crew, but it just went away. And the remote control is just like a GPS device, you know, to get his location from the main ship. And from 1 year later, he brought his crew, the other aliens, to the Earth with the proper precautions. You know, now he knows everything about Earth and the human being.
And he will never come back, maybe.
Okay, Leila, may I ask you? So, you know, the aliens came to the Earth, right? And fixed it one marriage. Is it enough for visit or not? Oh, or we expect more. You know, the universe is huge, right? Endless in the universe. There are only two civilizations, ours and theirs. And they came there, fixed the marriage of this Jerry girl and went away. Is it okay?
Oh, yeah. I could be volunteer.
Divine intervention.
Best of you.
Believe me, I have met a lot of you online and I love you more than the people I see every day. Believe me. I'm just fed up.
It's odd, yeah.
Okay, so but we didn't mention there were a lot of dancing, a lot of singing. It was beautiful.
No,
also
I have a lesson, you see.
Yeah.
Yeah, religions must not be used like this.
It's my
even
belief.
Hinduism, the yeah. guy, the guru, you know, just try to take the advantage.
Yep.
And I don't know.
Yeah, they took a safety stand, you know. They didn't say that God doesn't exist in the end, you know. There must have someone, but you have to dial the right number, you know. Don't believe in wrong numbers.
Well,
tonight I will try.
I strongly believe that humankind eventually misuse any tool, you know. Whatever you give them, they will misuse it. For certain, so it's what happened to religion thing. It what will happen to our governments already happened. So it will happen to everything. Just give some time. So it will be.
You're right. We forget how to be happy, how to content with what we have. I don't know.
Okay, thank you very much. Actually, I enjoyed the
and
movie,
right? I would like to say, please give me permission. Because I'm not going to be here for almost 2 months.
Yeah.
I will try to join from time to time. I will miss you. Stay safe and healthy.
Yeah. So you're going for vacation, right?
I'm going to take my mom to the Marmara Sea. Unfortunately, we can't swim because of the sea saliva.
Is it? I don't know what it is.
Even for the first time in my life, I have learned about this sea saliva. It is because of contamination. People are just, you know, polluted everywhere.
Yeah, I understand. Well, yeah, sad. Okay, Leila, actually, I don't know, will we be able to keep our classes? Usually at summer, we have a problem with attendance. So,
no, I will try, but there's no internet. I will just have my mobile internet, right? Yeah. I will put some units, and maybe I can't stay with this long, but I will try to join.
Yeah, try to join. You need some kind of headset. It's enough, you know. Mobile phone and headset. You don't need anything else. If you need, you know, to read the chat or to show the picture, we will find a way. Don't worry about this, you know.
Okay, my friend. Okay.
You know, Leila, you can buy a spare battery. It looks like a cell phone.
Yeah.
And you plug it into your phone, and it'll give you like 6 or 7 or 8 hours of power.
Well, it's like
really how many
small box.
I said, how many, if it's the right word, how many gigabytes do you think I need for a class like this?
Yeah, I can tell you. For one session, you need like 100 megabytes or something. So for 10 classes, you need 1 gigabyte for 10 classes.
Okay.
She's talking about, I think, battery power, right? You're talking about chargers?
Right. Yeah.
One's good for like 6 hours, isn't it? Or...
Yeah, charges, and she asked for internet traffic, so amount of gigabytes. So 1 gigabyte is enough for 10 classes.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Next week, I could join if we don't go, because there is a possibility that leaving Ankara on Monday. Okay?
Okay, I see. Yeah, it will be challenging time this summer, but anyway, Leila, we will miss you. We will miss classes.
I miss everybody, believe me. You're my ex-friends.
Yeah, don't leave me. If we stop our classes, I will not have a chance to speak English anymore, you know. So it's the only hour in the week when I speak English. So I need
okay. Okay. Take care. Wawa, bye-bye, Wawa.
Bye-bye. Thank you. See you next week. Bye-bye.
Yvonne, are you still having meetups once in a while, or do you quit going to those?
Nowadays, it's almost impossible. These meetups, people are scared of many things, of COVID, or some of them ask for tests, so I don't know. I don't like this. Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye.